coverage you can count on.
A new twist tonight regarding newly elected state representative Patricia Roybal Caballero, the woman now being investigated for possible voter fraud. Caballero claims she has a new address. It is now the third one she has listed under her name. Target 7's Angela Brower explains.
It's a story you only saw here on Target 7, a complaint filed against Patricia Roybal Caballero, claiming she doesn't live in the district she ran for. The official complaint claims Roybal Caballero ran in District 13 under one address, but really lives at another address listed in District 14. According to New Mexico law, that would mean she was ineligible to run. So the state started investigating, trying to clarify where in Albuquerque she truly lives. Roybal Caballero had her chance to respond. Her attorney sent this letter saying the allegations are incorrect. Vargas Law Firm claims that Roybal Caballero is registered to vote in District 13, and that should be good enough. The letter goes on to say that regardless, 1 week after the election, Roybal Caballero and her husband closed on a new piece of property located in District 13. So we went there, knocking, trying to track her down once again. No one was around. No answer to our phone calls. No answer to our emails.
We even tried tracking down Patricia Roybal Caballero's attorney, but couldn't get a hold of him either.
We called three times, even went to his office. We were told he was unavailable. So we went back to the house that Roybal Caballero supposedly lives in District 14. Numerous people tell us she still rents and lives there. But again, nothing. The homeowner here tells us she paid December rent, and it's at this District 14 house that she's still receiving mail. The Secretary of State's office hopes to finish the investigation soon, but they have yet to go to any of her listed addresses. In Albuquerque, Angela Brower, KOAT, Action 7 News.
The Secretary of State's office tells us they don't know yet whether she'll face criminal charges or if she'll be removed from her seat in the House of Representatives.